Good evening, teacher.
Good evening.
Hello, hello, welcome. Ok, muy ya estamos conectados alrededor de 4 personas. Muchas gracias por su puntualidad. Espero que hayan tenido un excelente viernes y culminarlo de la mejor manera con una clase de inglés. La clase número 9, si no me equivoco. Clase 9. Ok, ya casi a mitad. Ya casi vamos a hacer el midterm. El midterm. Ya vamos quedando con la tarea número 2. Ya pueden ir avanzando.
Literador Aaron Toño.
¿Cómo
estamos, mister?
Muy bien,
¿no? ¿Qué? La terminamos ayer, Bau. A medio, ¿no? Pero lo salió algo. Y el Nicolás ya no se perdió, guau, ya no la llamo ayer.
Creo que le estaba fallando el internet.
Sí, está fallando. El Claro siempre falla. ¿Cómo está siempre en el sector 10?
Sí, siempre.
Está bueno, me llega. Fecha, quiero ver. Hoy es 11, 12, 12 va.
Sí.
Okay, well, good evening to everyone. Let's start class. Ok, vamos a hacer el primer tomado de asistencia. Recordarles también la cámara activa, participar durante las clases. Ok, vamos a iniciar. Mr. Alexander Aaron.
Presente.
Arely del Carmen Cortés de Peña. Brenda Lizeth García Orellana. Carolina Eleonor Cardona de Alvarado. Edgar José Cruz Amaya.
Present.
Elvin Alexander. Erika Beatriz Urbina Guardado. Erika Present. Beatriz. Francisco Antonio. Francisco Antonio. Heidi Marisol. Heidi Marisol. Present. Jenny Marisol Escobar. Thank you very much. Jenny Marisol Escobar Hernández. José Nicolás García Maravilla.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, sir. Juan Alberto Rivas. Juan Ricardo Alvarenga Alas. Juan Ricardo Menedemo Delgado Vázquez.
Present, teacher.
Laura Noemí Rivas Rivas. Maritza Reyes López. Thank you. Ronald Alexis Gómez Mendoza. Sonia Miriam.
Present, teacher.
Wilmer Fabricio.
Present. Good evening.
Good evening. Welcome. All right, let's start. Okay, can you see my presentation? Yes, right? Thank you.
Yes.
Okay, let's refresh the use of may and might. May and might. And we said the previous class that these two modal verbs, they both express possibility. Ellos expresan posibilidad. Por ejemplo, usted ve un par de nubes y dice, hey, it might rain. It might rain or it may rain. Ok, también tenemos una, traigo también esta información que me pareció muy importante para el uso de may and might. Y dice que ambos expresan posibilidad, possibility, possibility. For example, it might rain later, so take an umbrella. It may watch a movie tonight. Ok, also give permission. En este caso, solamente may, para dar permiso, may. For example, you may have another cookie if you like. Puedes tener, puedes tener otra galleta si tú quieres. También expresa permiso, pero en el caso de may. Ok, ask for permission, para pedir permiso. Por ejemplo, para cuando decimos que si podemos ir al baño, podemos decir, hey, may I go to the bathroom? May I go to the bathroom? May I tell you something? Okay, cuando pedimos la palabra, ask for permission. Y tenemos las dos oraciones. Tenemos May I borrow your pen, please? May I have some water, please? Okay, también para expresar deseos. May you both live a long and happy life. Para expresar deseos. May the new year bring your happiness. May you both live a long and happy life. Okay. También tenemos esos dos ejemplos. These tables may produce side effects. Kids may be scared by the image. Ok, también esta pequeña información. Ok, esto dice que may and might can normally interchange without a significant difference in meaning. Pueden ser intercambiados sin ningún problema, sin ningún cambio de la estructura o sentido de la oración. Pero might a menudo implica una pequeña posibilidad de que ocurra algo en comparación de may. Pero esto es como ya demasiado ser meticuloso con la gramática, ir a profundidad, y usted que puede expresar que may tiene mayor oportunidad de que pase algo y might puede representar un 40%. Pero eso ya es como ir a la raíz, ¿verdad? A la hora de hablar no le preguntan cuál tiene mayor posibilidad. Usted va a utilizar el que a usted le convenga más. ¿Ok? May or might. Let's continue. Ok, here we have some sentences. Mr. Menedemo, help me to read the number one, please.
I may wish another special day.
Can you say it again, please?
Mm-hmm.
¿Puede leerle nuevamente?
I might watch.
I might
watch.
Watch.
Another
episode. Thank you. Okay. Thank you very much. Vamos con Mr. Juan Alberto. Number two, please.
Okay.
You may bring a partner to our event.
Event. Can you please repeat after me? Event.
Event.
Excellent. All right. Miss Sonia, help me to read this example. Your microphone, Miss. Miss Sonia?
Sorry. She might tell us what happened if we ask her.
Excellent. Mr. Alexander, please.
It might rain this afternoon.
Excellent. Miss Jenny, this example, please.
They might go to the beach this weekend.
Perfect. Excellent. Mr. Nicholas, the last one.
We might buy invited.
We may be invited.
We might be invited, but I am not sure.
Excellent. Very good. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, aquí tenemos un par de ejemplos para el uso de might and need. Okay, vamos a desarrollar un ejercicio. Okay. Okay, well, dejé el link del ejercicio en el chat para que podamos practicar este día el uso de may and might. May and might. Recuerden, ambos pueden ser utilizados para expresar posibilidad. May puede ser utilizado como para pedir permiso para hacer algo. Por ejemplo, may I go to the bathroom? May I tell you something? Okay, the exercise that you are doing is this, only 6 sentences. Okay, when you finish, please let me know. Okay, ¿quién quiere decir el número uno? Who wants to tell number one?
Me, teacher.
Okay, Elvin, thank you.
You may be sick.
Okay, you?
May be sick.
You might?
You might be sick.
Excellent. How about number two? Who has number two?
Jenny may have a fever.
Jenny may have fever. Okay, got it. Third?
My leg may be broken.
Okay. Broken. My leg may be broken. Perfect. Excellent. Let's see four.
We might need an ambulance.
We might
need an ambulance.
Ambulance. Good. An ambulance. Okay, fifth.
The doctor may be busy,
ocupado, busy. Como bicicleta, busy. Okay, is in the last one.
Some aspirin might help your headache.
Headache. Dolor de cabeza. The headache. Mistype. Okay. Eight. I'm sorry. Coloqué mal leg. Escribí mal leg. Puse que. Okay, I'm so sorry. Okay, got it. So we practiced a little bit about might and may. Both express possibility. Okay, may we use for ask for permission. Good job. Okay, let's continue. Okay, we have this question. What opinions would you give your customer if a product you offer is not good condition? What opinions would you give your customer if a product you offer is not good condition? ¿Qué opinión o qué respuesta le daría a su cliente si uno de los productos que usted ofrece no están en buenas condiciones? Okay, we're gonna think in this question for a minute, and then we're gonna share our answer. Vamos a meditar en esta pregunta. Después vamos a dar solución a lo que usted considera que haría. Okay, para pensar en que uno de sus productos que usted ofrece no sirve o tiene alguna falla, ¿qué respuesta le diera a su cliente? Okay, to your customer. In English, of course. Okay, what opinion would you give your customer if a product you offer is not good condition? Okay, who's ready?
Me, teacher.
Thank you, Mr. Wilmer, for being volunteer. There we go.
For example, I will say that you may turn it back in 5 days, or I will give you a special day to turn it back the product.
Okay.
For example.
Turn it back. Okay. You will tell that to your customer. Okay. To come back. Okay. All right. How about Miss Laura? What would you do if one of your product were on bad condition?
I ask to the client he follow the instruction manual. No sé cómo se dice.
Mm-hmm. Manual.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Good. Okay. Muy bien. Okay. Como estamos hablando de casos hipotéticos, que no son reales, vamos a iniciar con I would ask, I would tell, I would give it back, ¿ok? Vamos con Mr. Alexander.
Sorry, I can change for new for other products.
Okay, you would change for another product. Okay, good. Miss Jenny, what would you do?
Okay, could you specify what were the drawbacks for you in the product?
Okay, good. Would you give another product? Would you give different product, new one? Miss Jenny?
Yeah.
Okay. How about Miss Sonia?
I say the product is in offer and doesn't have warranty.
Ah, okay. Okay, good strategy. The product is in offer or on sale and doesn't have warranty. Perfect. How about Miss Erika? ¿Qué haría usted, Miss? Si uno de sus productos está en malas condiciones. What would you do?
Pensé que decía que pusiéramos un ejemplo de. Porque había salido mal el producto. Entonces yo okay. Lo hice así, ¿verdad?
Denos el ejemplo.
I want the product was already open when I received it.
Okay. The product was open when you received it. Perfect. Miss Carolina?
Sorry, teacher.
What is your opinion about this question?
And product change present in your purchase receipt.
Okay, good. Good strategy. The purchase receipt. Perfect. Muy bien. Okay. Vamos con una palabra nueva de este día. Okay. ¿Cómo creen que se dice cuando usted recibe un producto malo, pero usted quiere una devolución? ¿Cómo diríamos esa palabra en inglés? How would you say that in English?
Cashback. Cashback.
Okay. Well, the vocabulary it is refund. Refund. Okay. For example, vamos a suponer que usted compró unas rosas para el Día de la Madre, pero esas rosas que usted solicitó en a100flower.com están malas. Ok, usted las quería con chocolates y con otras decoraciones y no llegaron esas decoraciones y las flores estaban marchitas. Entonces usted necesita el dinero, okay, de vuelta. Entonces decimos, I need a refund. Refund.
Reembolso.
Exacto. Refund. Okay, that is the word. Griffin. Okay, and here we have this problem. Tenemos este lo puesta información la pueden encontrar en su manual. We have this problem. And it says sender name and address. Waterlux Inc., Travel Inc., 23, Glenway, San Carlos, 0570. Que tenemos el nombre de el que envía y la dirección. Y dice la nota. Please note, Waterlux customer satisfaction warranty is 90 days from date of purchase. Retain a copy of your records and close the original with the merchandise. Use one line per item. All the guarantees are not reported in each space. All items returned will require the original order number report of the form so credit can be processed. Okay, vamos a ir. Merchandise. Merchandise is mercancía. Merchandise. Merchandise. Warranties. ¿Qué es warranty?
Garantía.
¿De cuánto es la garantía de este producto?
90 days.
90 days.
90 días.
¿Desde cuándo inicia la garantía? ¿Desde el día de o desde la fecha de?
Compra.
Compra. La compra. ¿Qué necesita para mantener la warranty? Una copia de copy of
records
en y mantener el origen, mantenerlo envuelto en mantener envuelto su mercancía. Ok, entonces ¿cuál es el número del producto? Item number. Item number. Ahí está el número. ¿Cuántos son? Quantity. Six. Ok. Six. Ok. ¿Cuándo fue la fecha de la compra?
11, 23, 27, 23.
Ok. Good. ¿Cuál es la razón porque él pide un refund?
Missing part.
Ok, hacen falta ciertas partes. Como pueden ver, la D significa, acá dice el recent code, es un código. La D significa dissatisfaction, PP, product performance. No está satisfecho con la función del producto. Okay, entonces aquí tenemos un reclamo, a recent code. Ok, ahora tenemos esas tres preguntas basadas en el cartel que acabamos de ver. Y dice la número uno. What are the reasons the customer wants a refund? Would the customer get the refund? Would the customer get the refund and why? ¿Ustedes qué creen? Vamos a, número uno dice, ¿cuáles son las razones porque el cliente quiere el reembolso? El customer tendrá el reembolso. ¿Por qué?
Missing part.
The customer wants a refund missing part.
Because
the customer wants a refund missing part.
No, the customer wants a refund because there are missing some parts.
Okay.
Thank you. Ok, there we go. Vamos a... Vamos con Mr. Alexander. What are the reasons the customer wants a refund?
Because the customer report the missing part.
Missing part? Okay, good. Miss Laura, what are the reason the customer wants a refund?
Refund.
The customer is want a refund is for a missing part.
Okay, good. Miss Erika Urbina, what are the reason the customer wants a refund?
Because the product performance is bad.
Okay, good job. Ahora la pregunta número dos. Question number two. Would the customer get the refund? Why? ¿Qué consideran ustedes? ¿Si lo va a conseguir o no lo va a conseguir? Mr. Wilmer?
I think no, he wouldn't.
Why not?
Maybe the agent is going to send back the missing parts.
Okay. How about Miss Sonia? Okay, good. How about Miss Sonia? What do you think? Would the customer get the refund?
I think no. Because the company maybe send the missing parts.
Okay. So you think he wouldn't get the refund? All right. How about Mr. Juan Alberto Rivas? What do you think?
I think the customer no have the one ref from why and the product is poor.
Because
the product is poor.
Okay, got it. How about Miss Brenda? Miss Brenda Lizette, what do you think, Miss? Question number two.
And my opinion, maybe not, because they can give you the missing part.
Okay, good. How about Mr. Edgar? What do you think? Would he get the refund back?
I don't think so, teacher. Because if he doesn't have the document that is required, he wouldn't have the refund.
Got it. Okay, good job. Okay, very good. Just give me a second. Muy bien. Okay, vamos a ver. El uso de would. Solo un segundito. Ok. ¿Pueden ver la información?
Yes.
Excelente. Ok, yes. Vamos con el uso de would. Y como ustedes pudieron ver en la respuesta, utilizamos bastante would. Y bueno, en realidad el uso de would hay alrededor de tres formas, pero en esta vez nos vamos a enfocar en would como deseo de algo. Ok, una forma más formal de expresar deseo. Por ejemplo, me gustaría, compraría, bailaría. Ok, así funciona en esa estructura. We use the modal expression would like in English to talk about our desires and wants. Utilizamos would. Por ejemplo, would like, I would like, me gustaría, como un auxiliar para la hora de expresar deseos o algo que usted quiere. Would like is a more formal way to say want. Por ejemplo, cuando decimos me gustaría, es más formal que decir yo quiero, ¿verdad? Me gustaría, ok, es más formal que decir I want, yo quiero. Y aquí tenemos unos ejemplos. Por ejemplo, dice, I would like to take a trip. Me gustaría tener o tomar un viaje. I would like to take a trip. Como pueden ver, está expresando su deseo de una forma más formal. For example, Miss Laura, where would you like to take a trip? For example, in my case, I would like to take a trip to Roatán right now. How about you?
I would like to take a trip Machu Picchu.
Machu Picchu, oh, beautiful. Yeah, I would like to. How about Miss Carolina? Where would you like to take your trip?
I don't understand.
Okay, vaya. La expresión would like significa me gustaría. Entonces yo le pregunto a dónde le gustaría ir de viaje. Entonces usted me tiene que contestar, I would like to go to Paris, por ejemplo. I would like to go to Mexico.
I would like to take.
I do like the libertad.
Go. Go
to, okay, go to the hospital. Perfect. How about Miss Jenny? Where would you like to take a trip?
I would like to go to Panama.
Panama. Perfect. Good job. Okay, let's continue. Continuamos con los ejemplos. Dice, Sandra and her husband would like to have a June wedding. A June wedding. The example number three, it says, Carl would like a raise, but he is too nervous to ask his boss. Okay, a él le gustaría un ascenso, pero él está demasiado nervioso para pedírselo a su jefe. Okay, una forma más formal de expresar algo que usted quiere. Next. Tenemos el present tense or general desires. Por ejemplo, dice el ejemplo uno. I would like a house by the ocean. Me gustaría una casa cerca del puerto de la libertad. I would like a house by the ocean. Or they would like to improve their English. Me gustaría mejorar. Okay, o a ellos les gustaría mejorar su inglés. Okay, I would like to take an Italian class someday. My family would like to visit San Diego soon. Okay, son deseos en el futuro o también deseos en presente. Como pueden ver, esta expresión, cuando utilizamos would like, no va separado por ninguna preposición. Ok. Y, aquí está. Por ejemplo, la forma correcta sería I would like to win the lottery. Pero si usted dice, I would like win, es una forma incorrecta. Repito, la forma correcta sería I would like to win y no I would like win. Ok, bueno, traje más ejercicios para practicar el would. Ahorita lo pongo. Okay, what would you like to do? What would you like to do? Okay, la forma afirmativa es would y la forma negativa es wouldn't. Seguimos. Okay, basada en la fotografía, ¿qué le gustaría hacer? What would you like to do next summer?
Ellos quieren bañarse en la playa.
A ellos les gustaría
bañarse en la playa.
¿Cómo diría eso en inglés? Okay, I would like to go to the beach. I would like to go to the beach. Okay, based on this picture, what do you think she would like to go or she would like to do? ¿Qué le gustaría hacer? Miss Jenny?
I would like to swim on dolphin.
Okay, with the dolphin. I would swim with dolphins, or I would like to swim with dolphins. Okay, next. What about you, Peter? ¿Qué pasa con Peter? ¿A él no le gusta? ¿A él no le gustaría? Miss Laura?
He wouldn't.
Excellent. He wouldn't
go to the beach.
Perfect. He wouldn't, or he wouldn't like to go to the beach. O como se dijo, he wouldn't go
le,
to the
beach. Eso le quería preguntar. Para el negativo se le agrega también like to.
Es que, digamos, el like significa gustar, ¿verdad? Entonces tiene que estar juntos. Si queremos decir a él no le gustaría. He wouldn't like, or I wouldn't like. No me gustaría. Después va la preposición to, más el verbo que significa go, que es ir. Entonces en esta oración dice, no me gustaría ir. I wouldn't like to go.
Okay.
No me gustaría ir. Pero si se quiere decir no iría, se dice I wouldn't go.
Las dos estarían correctas entonces.
Las dos estarían correctas. Okay. En una diría me gustaría o no me gustaría ir, y en la otra diría no iría.
Okay.
Okay. Next, it says, what would you like to do next summer? What would you like to do next summer? Mi Sonia?
I would like to go to the volcano.
Okay, perfect. She would like to visit the volcano. Perfect. Miss Jenny, what would you like to do next summer?
I would like to climb the mountain.
Excellent. Perfect. Good job, Miss.
Oh, yeah.
Mountains. All right. Okay, how about Mr. Edgar?
I would like to camping in the snow.
Excellent. Excellent, very good. Mr. Alexander?
I would like to go to Alaska.
Alaska, okay, to the hospital. Perfect. Okay, and it says, what would you like to do on your birthday? ¿Qué le gustaría hacer en su cumpleaños? Miss Jenny, what would you like to do on your birthday?
I would like to visit my family.
Visit your family, perfect. Mr. Juan Alberto, what would you like to do on your birthday? Not beautiful, birthday.
Okay, I would like to do rock and the piñata.
Okay, to hit the piñata, to punch the piñata. Hit perfect. The piñata. Miss Carolina, what would you like to do on your birthday?
I would like bake.
I would like cake.
Bake cake.
Excellent. Okay, I would like to bake cake. I would
make
like
cake.
To bake cake.
Como ustedes sabrán, Miss Carolina, ella puede hacer pasteles, así que si necesitan uno, ya saben. Ok, después del anuncio, Mr. Wilmer, what would you like to do on your birthday?
I would like to eat a chocolate cake.
Excellent. Me, I like a chocolate cake too. How about Miss Erica? What would you like to do on your birthday?
I would like to go para reventar la piñata.
Hit the piñata. I would like to hit.
Ya lo habían dicho entonces, va.
Yeah, but la semana, no importa.
Okay. I would like to hit.
De piñata. Okay, o de piñata.
Mire, hermanita, tengo una duda.
Who like to have a party with
y his friends?
Perfect. Next one, it says, what would you do at your birthday? Okay, this is already, she would like to eat pizza. Next one, it says,
I would like to get drunk.
Ah, okay.
Y que nos la mande, que nos la mande en PDF para nosotros.
Okay. What do you think, based on the picture, what he would like to eat?
He would like to eat ice cream.
Perfect. An ice cream, perfect.
Like ice cream.
Okay, Miss Sonia, what would you like to do at the weekend?
I would like to go to the...
I'm sorry, where?
I would like to visit the... La Rueda.
Okay, so it's an amusement park. Very amusement park.
Amusement.
Excellent. Okay, how about Mr. Juan Alberto Rivas? What would you like to do this weekend?
I would like to ride the roller coaster. Yes.
Okay, to ride the roller coaster. I would like, repeat it for me. I would like to ride the roller coaster. Okay, Peter, he wouldn't like to go to the theme park or the amusement park. He wouldn't, negative form, he wouldn't. Okay, Miss Erika, ¿qué le gustaría hacer el fin de semana? What would you like to do this weekend?
I would like go, I was in a movie.
To watch? Ver? To watch?
Watch the movie.
Okay, to watch a movie. I would like to watch a movie. Perfect.
Oh.
¿Qué tipo de película le gustaría ver? What kind or what type of film would you see? Miss Laura?
I would like to action movie.
Action movie. Mr. Menedemo?
What you like, I is for to cheat. Hi to why? I want to.
¿Qué tipo de película le gustaría ver? What kind of movie would you like to see?
Viajeros en el tiempo.
¿Qué tipo de película es? Action. Love.
Action.
Ah, okay.
Action would, okay.
Repite después de mí. I would like.
I you like.
I would.
I would.
Like.
Like.
To watch.
To watch.
Action.
Action.
Movie.
Movie.
Excellent. Okay. Very good. And Stephanie. Okay. Bien. Vamos a ir a la página 26, page 26, please. This one, page 26. Done? Okay. Vamos a desarrollar estas oraciones. Tenemos complete the following statement or question. I would like to. Will she? Aquí hay un error ortográfico, pero es wouldn't. She wouldn't. La número 4, ustedes solo ven, ven la D, ¿verdad? Esa es la contracción de would. La forma más corta. Would.
¿Puede repetir la pronunciación, por favor?
¿De qué es? Would, wouldn't.
De la contracción que acaba de mencionar.
Would like. Would, con una D. Would like.
Thank you.
Would like, I would like, or she would, she'd like, they'd like.
Teacher, una consulta.
Dígame, mister. Miss.
Cuando se usa el would, solo si se usa el like, es que se debe poner el to. I would like to. Pero si usted lo pone el solo, I would change, ahí ya no es would change.
Ya, ahí, en este caso ya no sería, si usted dice quiere cambiar, yo sería I would change. O no, perdón, si usted quiere decir yo cambiaría, entonces ahí diría, I would change. Pero si usted quiere decir, a mí me gustaría cambiar, usted ahí sería, I would like to change. Únicamente si va a agregar el verbo like.
Like to.
Ah, para decir me gustaría. I would like to play.
I would like to change.
I would like to change.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, are you ready? Are you ready with number one? I would like to.
I would like to stand mine.
Is Juan Alberto Rivas?
I would like to travel for space.
Okay, you would like to travel through the space. Excellent, to the space. Very good, very creative. Let me see, Mr. Benedemos. Número uno, la respuesta de la número uno.
Would you like achieve statement or question?
Got it.
Correcto.
¿Qué quiere decir en la número uno, Miss?
Complementar el formulario, estar de la cuestión.
No, no, no. La número
la
uno.
Oración.
¿Qué quiere colocar en la número uno? Sí.
Permítame.
Okay.
This product.
Okay, okay. I'm sorry, mister. Can you say that again? Okay, well, number two, would she, Nicolás, Mr. Nicolás? Number two?
Would she like to buy a new car?
Would she like to buy a new car? Excellent. Number five. No, let me see. I'm sorry.
Was she married with boyfriend?
Was she married with boyfriend? Okay. Okay. How about number? It says Mr. Trujillo wouldn't.
Wouldn't like to work on Saturday.
Yeah, me too. Me neither. Mr. Trujillo wouldn't like to work on. Okay, very good. Okay, how about we would like to or we'd like to? Les voy a pedir que si no participan, tengan apagado el micrófono para que no se filtre el sonido, por favor. Okay. Is there? Okay.
Bye bye. Are there again?
Okay, thank you.
Would like to play the volleyball on Saturday.
Yes. Okay, perfect, excellent. Okay, five, she wouldn't.
Like to stay home?
To stay at home, perfect. She wouldn't like to stay at home. Another opinion, number five? Different opinion? Different answer?
You should like to have a refund.
Would you like to have a refund? Perfect. Number five? Number five?
You wouldn't like to have a refund.
Okay, let's go with Miss Sonia, please. Number five.
She wouldn't stay in at the park.
At the park, perfect. Okay, number six. Who has number six? Why don't you? Ok, nos quedamos con like Miss Sonia.
Would you like to swim?
Perfect.
Y lleva error, ¿verdad? Escuchar el texto.
Sí, tiene error, tiene dos.
Dos errores.
Ok. Bueno, ahora vamos a vamos a hacer una actividad en grupo. Vamos a vamos a crear 5 oraciones utilizando would like. ¿Qué le gustaría hacer? Ya sea en este fin de semana, el siguiente año, la siguiente vacación. ¿Quién le gustaría hacer? Ok, lo vamos a realizar en parejas. Ok, al venir vamos a compartir cada uno de sus experiencias, cada uno de sus respuestas. Ok. Would like. There you go.
¿Cómo es de? ¿Basados en qué, profe? Disculpe.
Utilizando would. Would.
Ajá, sí, pero ¿en qué contexto?
Puede ser en su, ¿qué le gustaría hacer en la siguiente vacación, el siguiente fin de semana? O cosas que simplemente le gustaría hacer.
Sí, es que no lo escuché bien, se me cortó la señal.
No se preocupe, entiendo. finish.
Almost down.
Almost down, good.
Yes, true.
Yes, teacher.
Shopping.
Hello, Pena.
Todavía no, teacher.
Got it.
Solo una falta, teacher. Ya, okay. Ya vamos. Vaya, ¿cuál es la otra, ña Marisol?
Yo ya dije varias, le toca a usted. Usted.
Teacher.
Yes.
What do you say? Reventar cohetes, pero I know fireworks, but reventar, ¿cómo es?
Reventar. Ah, está difícil, no. Que ver.
Nosotros decimos, vamos a reventar cohetes.
Bueno, ¿cómo sería una forma formal de decir reventar? Explotar, ¿verdad?
Explosion.
Puede ser blow up. Explotar. Blow up.
Fire.
Explode up. Ah, I would like explode firework.
Blow up, porque si solo la palabra blow significa otra cosa, pero es blow up.
Ah.
Reventar o explotar.
Uh-huh.
Por ejemplo, se puede decir la bomba va a explotar, the bomb, la casa, por ejemplo, está en llamas, blow up.
Okay. Sí, estaba. Eso queríamos decir.
Es like blow to... up.
Blow.
Blow. B-O-W. B-O-W. Blow up.
Blow up.
Uh-huh.
Como soplar.
Arriba. Si lo traduce literalmente.
Soplar arriba. Ajá. Uh-huh.
Pero como es un verb, un modal verb, eso es diferente.
Ah, ok.
Los modal verbs. Los monoverbs, si se los trata de traducir, literalmente está perdido ahí.
¿Y cuando se dice blow your mind?
Blow your mind, es que le explotó la cabeza, que está sorprendido ahí.
Ah, es que eso sí lo estaba escuchando en una canción, blow your mind. Como que sopla tu cabeza o sopla tu mente. Algo así.
Pues se imaginaba a alguien ahí soplándole.
Ajá, yo me quedo así y eso tan literal así va, pero
como dicen,
ajá, como a veces una palabra en inglés tiene otro significado, de manera literal. Pero cuando decimos thank you, gracias, es, supuestamente es toma tú, sería va, inglés. Bueno,
sí. ¿Toma qué?
Toma tú. Thank you. Toma tú.
No.
Take you. Sí, así, literal, sí.
No.
No. ¿Cómo sería?
Thank you es thank you, gracias. Es una palabra que tiene equivalencia.
Pero si usted desglosa la palabra, solo thank. Y you.
Ah, es take. No sé.
Take es tomar.
No, en serio. Pero la palabra solo thank.
No, es thank. Thank.
Thank. Mm-hmm.
Thank.
Mm. Es, no. Ah, es difícil.
Osman.
Ay, Dios mío, qué difícil es este idioma.
Es más fácil de todo.
Ah, pues sí.
Okay, are you ready? Excellent. Vamos a iniciar con Miss Laura, please. Miss Laura Rivas. then Miss Marisol, and then Miss Sonia.
Ah, las oraciones que sí, dijimos sí, claro. Todos, ¿verdad? Compartimos. Mm-hmm. Ok. I would like, bueno, Erika would like to sleep all the day.
Okay.
And Francisco wouldn't like to sick.
Okay.
And I would like to buy a new car.
Buy a new car, excellent, me too.
And that's it.
That's it, okay, got it. How about Miss Marisol?
Okay. Aaron would like to travel to London next year. Juan would like to party at night on the weekend. I wouldn't like to receive English class Thursday and Friday.
Okay.
I would like to go shopping on Black Friday.
Black Friday, but with money.
And would like to read a scary book.
Scary book. Okay, scary book. Perfect. Miss Sonia?
I would like to climb the volcano of Santa Ana again.
Oh, yeah.
On the next vacation. I would like to meet with my friends on Christmas. And I would like to learn other language next year.
Excellent. Excellent. Of course you will. Miss Brenda?
For example, Miss Carolina,
mm-hmm.
She would like to go to the shopping.
Shopping? Oh, good.
The next weekend. And she would like to watch a movie. And she would like to visit the family. And she would like to play soccer. And finally, she would like to eat pupusas.
Oh, me too, right now. I would like. Okay, let me see, Mr. Alexander.
I would like sick on Christmas. I would like have barbecue the next Sunday.
Oh yeah, delicious too. Miss Jenny, please, be my guest, Miss Jenny.
Okay, Jose Nicolas, he would like to play soccer. Teacher, how do you say football sala?
Soccer room.
Soccer room, ah, okay.
Or indoor room, or puede ser indoor, soccer indoor.
Soccer indoor, ah, okay. Jose Nicolas, he would like to play indoor, soccer indoor.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And he would like to fall asleep on Saturday morning. And he would like to go to the park on Sunday night.
Excellent. Good. How about Mr. Wilmer? Are you ready, Paz?
No, not yet.
Okay.
I was talking with Juan Alberto Rivas. He told me that he would like to spend all the time in his house, very drunk, and that's it.
Okay. All right, thank you. Okay, vamos a la siguiente actividad. Para los que les gusta hablar bastante en inglés, traemos la siguiente actividad. Se llama Your Favorite Famous Person. Your favorite famous person. Okay, en este caso vamos a escoger a un personaje que a usted le agrade, que sea famoso, que todos lo podamos conocer. Solamente será uno, puede ser actor, cantante, escritor, ok, lo que usted considere o usted le gustaría escoger. Y vamos a crear una presentación donde usted va a hablar por 2 minutos de su personaje favorito. Ok, 2 minutos. Le voy a asignar ahorita que trabajemos en grupo para que usted pueda ayudarse con sus compañeros, auxiliarse y después poder presentar individualmente. Are you ready? Okay, there we go. ¿Cómo vamos? ¿Ya vamos finalizando?
No, ahorita mire, ¿cómo que tenemos que decir las cualidades o algo que le gusta de ello?
Todo, Miss, lo que usted considere en 2 minutos. Vale. Su edad, cómo se describe, si es alto o bajito, qué lo hace famoso, si es cantante, si es escritor, si es filósofo.
Ya.
¿Qué canción le gusta de él? Si le gusta Navidad, otra Navidad sin ti. Cosas así.
Vaya.
Buena idea le está dando el teacher.
Teacher.
Dígame.
2 minutos tenemos que hablarles.
2 minutos. Muy poquito, ¿verdad?
No, mucho. Lo que pasa es que también, o sea, porque no tengo como, he pensado en un personaje, pero no tengo mucha información. Aunque no sé si todos lo conocen también.
I'm gonna talk about Martin Garrix.
He's a DJ, right?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Sonaje que yo he pensado es Malala Yousafzai.
Malala. 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 Ella es la de los derechos humanos, activista.
Sí, una activista, creo que de Afganistán, es que eso no estoy seguro.
creo, también hay, es un estilo de dibujo, ¿verdad? Me corrige usted.
Ah, Malala.
Sí. Ah, no, no, perdón, ese es mandala.
Ah, los mandalas. Sí, esos son los mandalas. Sí, solo que la historia de ella yo no la conocía, pero vi un reportaje en la televisión y nunca lo había visto, nunca no sabía la historia de ella. Pero sí, es muy interesante.
Sí, sí, bastante.
Teacher, ¿quién se va a quedar ahora en los 10 minutos?
Quiero ver. Marisol le toca. Más Marisol.
Ah, bueno. Ok, teacher.
Se salvó.
Sí, man, que vieron.
And the body knows.
Yeah.
Es solo para que vea el idioma, porque aparecen en muchos idiomas solo la palabra Jesús.
Jesús.
Ajá.
Ajá. Ya la puse, aquí la voy a escuchar. En lo que me concentro para hacer mi descripción.
Carolina is mute, man. I don't know why.
No, mister, usted tiene que darle
yo
ingresar.
Who, me?
Ella está en la, ella está afuera ahorita.
Sí. ¿Cómo?
Es que usted no ha ingresado al breakout room. Carolina, este es otro usuario que utiliza ella. Esta es la main room.
Ah, la breakout. Yo pensé que le ya había dado.
Si no, lo voy a mover a la otra.
Voy a caer ahí. Yo pensé que ella no. Ahí se me fue chupo.
No le aparece el mensaje.
Maybe I'm going to wait here. No, I couldn't get in, teacher.
Ya me fueron todas las ideas. Ya no hay que más poner.
Acuérdese de la novela, acuérdese de la
novela. ¿Cuál novela? Si ni tiempo de novelas queda, no moleste. Ahí solo usted que se las echa todas las del día. A ver, risa le daba.
¿De quién va a hablar usted, Brenda?
Yo, de Ricardo Arjona.
Ricardo Arjona, qué chido.
El problema es
que no sé qué decir.
No, usted diga la del problema es, el problema es, el problema es. El Arjona dice que tiene muchos problemas. Usted sí, ponga ahí.
El problema es ese que no sé qué decir. Yo no moleste. Solo sé que voy a hablar de él, pero no sé qué decir. No me tardo 2 minutos en lo que he pensado.
Es que usted dice, el problema es, y se queda ahí, ida un ratito y después, el problema es.
No, espérese. Ay.
¿Verdad, teacher? Que expreses todos sus sentimientos ahí ahorita.
Likeable.
Play.
Música clásica.
Ah, classic music.
Uh-huh. Guitarra clásica.
Uh-huh. What is the name? He's a black person. He's a black man from United States who plays a guitar very well. He already died long time ago. I don't remember his name.
Which class of music?
It's rock.
He play.
Yeah, it's. I don't know why when I try to talk about music, I don't remember the name of this guy.
It's a black famous guy.
Yeah, he's the number one in the world.
In the group, no.
The world. The number one is a nigger, man. But he's very good.
Hendrix.
Hey, Jimi Hendrix, yeah. Yes, one of the best. Also, George Harrison is another one.
Mm-hmm.
But when they play the guitar, they used to be like with cocaine, some drugs. That's the reason why they play very well.
Yeah.
That's it. We are talking about famous persons, but we have not decided which person to talk about.
It can be an actor, an actress, a singer, athlete, soccer player, basketball player.
Yeah. What do you think? I would like to meet Britney Spears, for instance.
Britney Spears.
I don't know. Maybe She is
so beautiful. Now. So beautiful.
In the past.
Ya avanzaron bastante.
Yo leyendo estoy que tenemos que hacer alguna diapositiva o algo parecido.
Pero ¿cómo vamos a hacer una diapositiva?
Dicho no la puso difícil. Ah, mentira.
¿Por qué, Miss?
Porque describir así como, ¿por qué nos agrada? Algo.
No, usted puede agregar información libre. O sea, si usted cree que eso no le gusta, lo omite y agrega otra información. Por ejemplo, sus éxitos.
¿Tiene...
Porque es famoso. Mm. A dónde nació. Si es alto, si es bajito. Okay. ¿Cuántos años tiene? Si está casado. O si está casada, no sé si es mujer o hombre. ¿Cuál es su nacionalidad? Si habla inglés, francés, mandarín, French.
Ok. Bueno.
Marisol, who is your famous person?
Oh, no. The candidate.
¿Quién es su...?
Surprise.
Ah, okay. Surprise. Marito Rivera. Marita.
Claro que no me gusta eso. Mi personaje es... Ah, puede ser animado, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Ah, okay. Entonces he elegido Frozen. Elsa de Frozen. Está bien.
Sí, está bien, pero que encuentre información.
Voy a hablar acerca de sus cualidades, porque me gusta, de sus valores y sobre sus características físicas.
Ok, excelente.
No sé qué nacionalidad es, la verdad voy a investigarlo para agregarle la nacionalidad.
American puede ser.
Ok, pero menciono que es una... Es una película de Disney, entonces la nacionalidad la voy a poner estadounidense, entonces.
Ok, American.
Ok, ok.
Está difícil cubrir los 2 minutos.
Yo creo en ustedes, lo van a hacer.
Teacher, pero, o sea, nos tardamos 2 minutos, pero podemos ir así como despacito. Elsa, tú is a beautiful y todo eso, así despacio.
A su velocidad, a su forma de que usted considere.
Ah,
que...
ok. Entonces sí, 2 minutos, pero así en esa velocidad tipo tortuga. Tú is a beautiful, para que lleve los 2 minutos, porque si no, no vamos a, al menos yo no voy a abarcar 2 minutos.
Sí, Miss, usted lo abarca, yo sé. Yo creo en usted, I trust on you.
I'm sorry, pero no creo. Bueno. Así que lo voy a decir despacio.
Got it.
Okay. Ay, pero está bien difícil, teacher. 1 minuto.
Me.
Finish.
Vaya, Delania, lea su autor.
Vaya. My favorite famous Romeo Santos, American actor. He is considered
in most of America, of the kid of the bachata, for bay the leader localist in May composer of the great aventura. My favorite music propuesta indecente.
Ahí está. Fue Mar Fortino Alonso Moreno Reyes. One, two, August. Thursday, April.
¿Qué dijo al final?
Pesado. Espérenme. Mario Fortino, Alfonso Moreno Reyes, 1-2 August, 1-9-1-20 April, 1-9-9-30 counts. A bright tie story number continues was a Mexico con male actor and children Mendes Arturo Moreno, nombre de que tiene como
el actor.
Ajá. Es hijo de don Mario Fortino Alfonso Mor Rey. Solo la mamá faltó. Y la ciudad va, solo eso, lo otro ya lo había escrito, va. Quiero ver Comedy, Lexo, Movies, Clutch, Cherry y Maurice. Es comedia, acción, suspenso y de tristeza. Acuérdese cuando saca de aquel niño que fue el ahijado, cuando fue profesor y le quemaron la escuela, cuando salvó la vida de aquel niño que iba a quedar ciego, todas esas películas. Y usted, el autor, dijo.
Es Romeo Santos, el cantante.
Ah, le gusta la música.
Sí.
¿Cristiana es?
No, romántica.
Ah, por eso lo llorando pasa. Vaya, entonces.
Okay, who wants to start?
Yeah, me, why not?
Okay, there we go. 3, 2, 1, action.
Okay, I'm going to talk about Alejandro San. When I was young, I used to listening rock music, and I didn't like and other kind of music, but hey, I like it so much, Alejandro San. Maybe because when he sings, he is very honest with his songs. And I fall in love with a girl, and I used that kind of music in order to get her. So it helped me a lot. And I remember that kind of music for those reasons that I had when I was young, long time ago. And I would like to meet him some days in my dream because he's very famous and he has a lot of money. So that's it.
That's it? Okay. Thank you very much for your participation, Mister. Okay, your participation was of a minute and 9 seconds. Good job. Okay, next, who wants to be next?
Me, teacher.
Okay, go ahead, miss.
My favorite person is Robert Landon. He is a fictional character created by author Dan Brown. He is a Harvard University professor of history of art and symbology. He is likable and has photographic memory. He knows how to entertain the crowd and keep the attention of him. Landon is the novel's protagonist in a lot of books of Dan Brown, like The Da Vinci Code, Inferno, The Lost Symbol. In the movie, his analysis capacity is amazing, and it's sought out by influential groups to solve complicated cases. I like River, these books, because it's very emotional. Finish.
Okay, good. Minute 16 seconds. Good job, miss. Congratulations. Okay, another volunteer.
Me, teacher.
Thank you, Mr. Edgar.
Okay, good night, everyone. This night I'm going to talk about Martin Garrix. He's one of my favorite DJs. When I was 15 years old, I listened for the first time in a festival music, electronic festival music. Martin Garrix was born in the Amsterdam on 14 May, and I remember that, and 1996. Currently, he has 25 years old, and he has a younger sister, and he lives with his parents. And Martin Garrix has spin records. This is his produced musical company, and the first time when he stayed in an electronic festival, he listened to DJ Tiesto, and in my case, my favorite song of Martin Garrix
is I don't remember the name is Tiger is the first song that he played in a festival, and also I would like to go to the Ibiza, and he has
time.
A discotheque.
Thank you very much. Okay, just a piece of advice and a recommendation. I heard, for example, he has 25, and the correct form it is, he is 25. He is 25.
He is, okay.
He's 25 years old. Okay, another volunteer.
Your teacher.
Miss Maritza, please. Yes. Excellent. There we go.
My favorite famous Romeo Santo. American actor. He is considered his most American of the kids of bachata for base the leader vocalist. A main composer of the Crow Aventura, my favorite music proposed in the center.
Oh, okay.
Finished.
Good. 38 seconds. Good job. Excellent, Miss. Thank you for being volunteer. Congratulations.
Me?
Okay. Okay, Miss Jenny, please be my guest.
Okay, I talk about for Adam Sandler. He was born on September 9 in New York City. And Adam Sandler is American, is a profession, not only is actor, is a professor and at North School. Is some for the, your father is a parent, is a Jewish, no, I don't say Judíos.
Jewish,
yeah. Jewish, okay. I like him because a fun, a charisma, witty. I can see his feel several times and I don't be bored. I see then he's a very keen person. In his film, he leave very interesting mentions about family, friends. Despite his fame, I can see that his personality does not change. My favorite movies of him are is the Jack and Jill, and there I like children. That's it.
Excellent. A minute seven. Good job, Miss Jenny. Good pronunciation and fluency.
Good teacher. Okay.
Mr. Juan, go ahead.
Autor Cantinflas. Comedy, lesson movies, clashes, fetchy movies. Biopics, factory, children, family life. Mario Fortino Alonso Moreno Reyes. Lucy Agus. One. 20 April 1993. Count a dice store. Nombre Cantinflas was a Mexican. Comer Arthur and children. Manager Arturo Moreno. Abrancho Reyes. Finished.
Good. Thank you, Mr. Excellent. Another volunteer?
Thank you, sir.
Mr. Alexander, and then Mr. Juan. Go ahead, Mr. Alexander.
I'm going to talk about Malala Yousafzai. I did not know the history of Malala, and coincidentally, recently, television channels, I saw her history. She is a Pakistani activist that living in the United Kingdom. When she was 15 years old, she suffered an attack that was on October 9, 2012. She received the Nobel base price in 2014, which was 17 years old. Being the young best person to receive that award, when she living in Pakistan, she denounced the abuses of the Taliban. They oppose the education of women in their country. She was named Messenger of Peace in 2014. Finished.
Excellent. Good time, Mister. Okay. Next, please.
Teacher.
Go ahead.
Yes. Good evening. I am talk about of the Maria Maria Salomea Slobowska. His name is Madame Curie. She has a water scientific. She discovered two elements, the type of periodic. The first is the polonium, and second is the radium. She was the first woman in wins to Nobel Prize. The first and Nobel Prize was in the area of the physics, and the second was the area of the chemical for and discovery the radiation. And she was the first woman in job in one university in the University of the Paris. He was the manager of and the supervision of the laboratory. This is university. She has two children, Ivan and Eve, and husband. His name was Pierre Curie. And this couple win one prize Nobel for cooperation and discovery the radiation in area of the physics. And then I remember he died for probably the hearings for cancer. And only that teacher.
Only that. Good job. Almost 2 minutes. Good job. Congratulations. Muy bien. Ok, debido al tiempo, vamos a detenernos en las presentaciones. Ok, vamos a tomar la asistencia de este día. Le agradezco mucho por su participación. Vamos a continuar en la siguiente clase. Ok, vamos a iniciar con Mr. Alexander Aaron.
Presente.
Arely del Carmen. Brenda Lisette.
Present.
Carolina Eleonor.
Present, teacher.
Edgar José.
Present, teacher.
Edgar José Cruz. Is there Elvin Alexander?
Present, teacher.
Erika present. Beatriz. Francisco Antonio Renderos.
Present.
Thank you, sir. Francis Heidi Marisol.
Present.
Jenny Marisol.
Present.
Jose Nicolás.
Present.
Juan Alberto Rivas.
Present, teacher.
Juan Ricardo Alvarenga. Juan Ricardo Menedemo.
Present, teacher.
Laura Noemí.
Present.
Maritza Reyes.
Present, teacher.
Ronald Alexis. Ronald Alexis. Sonia Miriam.
Present.
Wilmer Fabricio.
Present, present.
Okay, well, see you next class, guys. Take care, God bless you. Espero que tengan un excelente fin de semana. Recordarles que puedan hacer la tarea número 2, por favor, la tarea número 2. Okay, see you next week. Bye bye.
See you, teacher.
Bye. Thank you. See you. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Good night.
Teacher, ¿qué nos toca hoy?